ओके
यस
यस ज़ैनब, रीड दिस लेसन, रीड दिस पैराग्राफ, देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट.
ओके मैम. लेसन नंबर 8 ड्यूरिंग द मीडियल पीरियड. भगवा भगवा जीवन वैन वेंट ऑन टू ऑन अ टूर ऑफ द नॉर्थ इंडिया. She was interested in history, and so she noted down information about the rulers
of
the
land. It's she.
She noted down information about the rulers of the Delhi in her diary. This diary was read out in classroom. What was the read out is as below. Delhi.
Yes.
The Delhi Sultana was founded in the beginning of the 13th century, 1200 after the death of Ghori. One of his loyal slaves became the commander and established control over the kingdom of the Delhi. Thus the slave dynasty started ruling over Delhi. Ma'am?
Ma'am, beta.
Someone, mic is unmute.
Everyone's mic is mute, beta. Maybe they are muted right now. See that, girls, you keep your mic mute, okay? Yes, continue, beta.
The dynasty started ruling over the Delhi. Through his faced many difficulties in establishing his power in India, he managed to provide a stable administration. He had started the construction of a minar. His son-in-law, Iltutmish, succeeded in completing the minar. This minar has been known. Ma'am, Nayan is Modesa, mic is unmute.
Nayan is Modesa, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Nayan is Modesa.
I mean, my phone is mute.
Nayani Madhisa, please mute your mic.
Nayani Madhisa, please mute your mic. Nayani Madhisa. Nayani Madhisa.
Ma'am,
it's not mute, Nayani Madhisa.
No, ma'am, in my phone, it might be some problem there.
No, if your mic is mute, how can we listen to you, Nayani Madhisa?
Ma'am, I have unmuted from here.
So now mute it. Gugulam, can you mute it?
I cannot mute it. I can either pin her or I can remove or I can remove her. That's it.
Nayani Madhisa, you exit once and then you re-enter and then at that time you try to mute your mic. Chalo, do it fast. Okay. Yes, beta. Continue, Rupan
Zainab. The Iltutmish who succeeded him completed the construction of that minar. This minar, which came to be known as the famous Qutub Minar, is shown in the picture 8.1. The architectural style in which Qutub Minar was constructed is a mixture of the both Hindu and Muslim styles. This place was the capital during the Sultanan age.
Yes, very good. So, we learned so many things about Qutub Minar, yes?
Yes.
Yes, it is the construction, it is the combination of both the Hindu and Muslim architecture, right? Apart from that, it is what, one minute. One minute. Huh? Yes, how many, who completed the construction of Qutub Minar?
Iltutmish.
Yes, and who started the construction of Qutub Minar?
Qutubuddin.
Yes.
Qutubuddin Aibak.
Yes, Qutubuddin Aibak. And who was Razia Sultan?
The daughter of the Iltutmish daughter.
Hmm. And when did she come over the throne?
1236.
Very good. And how many floors was Qutub Minar constructed?
What,
five,
ma'am?
Five. How many floors Qutub Minar is?
Five.
Yes. Yes.
Five.
Hmm. Screen you can see, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So these are some facts about Qutub Minar. We'll revise that once.
Okay. Zainab? Yes, ma'am.
Can I revise? Can you revise it once?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Qutub Minar. These are 240 feet and 73 meters in height. Tallest minar in the world. It was built by the Qutub Minar. 1199. It is 14 meters and 3 meters at the peak. It has 5 stories connected by the balconies. It has a door in the north direction which leads to a circular stairway with 379 steps. Red sandstone. And marble in use for its construction. Verses of Quran and inscribed on it, floral motifs engraved on it.
Yes, very good. Understood till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so this was all about Qutub Minar. Now we will see about Razia Sultan. Revise about Razia Sultan. Yes. And yes, Naini Modisa.
Yes, read better.
Ma'am, can I read?
Naini Modisa is reading, I guess. Who was asking for permission?
Ma'am, can I read Sakina Rajani?
Yes, Sakina, who has started actually? Someone has started reading. Yes, Nayani Modisa, start. After Nayani Modisa, Sakina Rajani, you read, okay?
Iltutmish was also a slave in the beginning. He conquered many territories in India and made them a part of Delhi Sultanate. So he is known as the founder of the slave dynasty. His daughter Razia Sultan ascended the throne after his death in 12368. Razia was the first female ruler sultana to rule over Delhi. Razia was an efficient ruler. She used to dress as a maid when she was in the court. According to the historians of that time, Minhasi Sirat, Razia was a more capable and efficient ruler than her brothers. However, beginning being a woman, she was not accepted as a ruler.
She was not accepted. Kitna fast padte ho Naini Modisa. Right? Razia was more capable and efficient ruler than her brothers. But she was not accepted as a ruler. Why? Because everyone disliked her, right? As she was a woman, right? And more efficient than her brothers, right? Yes. Continue, beta.
Amir Umras disliked Razia Sultan as a ruler. Razia's rule came to an end due to the interference of the Amirs. There was complete disorders in the Sultanate for 6 years after her death. At last, Amir enthroned Nasiruddin, the son of Iltutmish. He ruled for 21 years. After his death, Ghiyasuddin Balban ascended the throne of Delhi. He was a strong ruler who brought an end to the disorder and established peace. Balban had been the wazir of Nasiruddin for 20 years. Subsequently, he ruled as Sultan for 22 years. His distanced were weak, for the Khilji dynasty established its rule over Delhi.
Yes, understood till here, everyone?
Yes.
Any doubt?
Yes, ma'am. No doubt. No doubt.
Very good. Chalo. If you revise properly, you know, you will be able to learn everything properly. Okay? So, see that you in the revision, you pay attention properly. Okay? Yes. So, now is the Khilji dynasty. After the slave dynasty. After the slave dynasty, the Khilji dynasty, right? Slave dynasty ke baad Khilji dynasty. Yes. Yes, say beta.
Mom, can I read?
Yes, read beta. You read now.
Within 4 years of the Balban's death, the Khilji dynasty established its rule over Delhi. Mm-hmm. The trunk committee who belong to Turk community who belong to Khilji, the Afghanistan was known as Khilji Jalaluddin Khilji bought and Jalaluddin Khilji bought an end to slave dynasty and in its place founded the Khilji dynasty in 1296 CE. Then Khilji was both his nephew and son-in-law overthrew Jalaluddin and became the ruler of Delhi. He was very
ambitious.
He controlled the interference of the Ulemas and Umbros in the state administration of Aluddin. Khilji formed a strict law control price. The famous poet Amir Khosrow, who works as well known as Android in his code. There was complete disorder in the kingdom after his death, and the Tulji dynasty established his power, replacing the Khilji.
Tughlaq
dynasty established its power, replacing the Khilji dynasty.
Yes. Any doubt till here, beta? Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Clear to all? No. Clear?
Yes.
Yes. Almas, now read the next. Tughlaq dynasty.
The Tughlaq dynasty. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq founded the Tughlaq dynasty within 4 years after the death of Alauddin Khilji. Bagh Chauki, the postal service, was started in his time. The letters were carried by horse riders. Postmen were referred to as Halkaro at that time. Halkaro at that time referred to Saurashtra in Rashda. To know more about Halkaro, Muhammad Tughlaq became the Sultan after Ghiyasuddin. Many of the decisions that he took are criticized. Among these, the two...
Wait a minute. Something went wrong. 1 minute. Huh? Yes. Yes, continue, beta.
Okay. Ma'am, but the screen is half not coming.
Ma'am, are these screen dikhai
de rahi hai? Can you see now?
Ma'am, the screen is coming half.
Acha, 1 minute.
अब
यस नाउ इट्स फुल मैम
अब ये
नाउ टेक्स्ट बुक हैज गॉन समवेयर 1 मिनट वेट ओके
ओके
Can see now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, continue then.
Among these, the two main plans were the transfer of capital from Delhi to Daulatabad and introducing
two main plans.
Were the transfer of capital from Delhi to Daulatabad and introducing the use of copper currency during Muhammad Tughlaq's regime, Abu Ibn Battuta, an African traveler from Tangier.
Sorry to interpret. It's not region, it's ring. Okay?
Okay. Ring Ibn Battuta, an African traveler from Tangier belonging to the Habsi tribe, visited India, criticizing the Sultan's administration. He was written the Muhammad Shah's rule was an amalgamation of both good and bad administrative policies.
Amalgamation is what? The combination of both, okay? Good and bad policies. Yes, now I'll ask you some questions till here. Huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I will ask you some questions.
Yes.
Okay. So, who established Tughlaq dynasty?
Muhammad.
Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. Who established Tughlaq dynasty?
Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq.
Ah, then why? Mistake. Then who established a slave dynasty?
Qutbuddin Aibak.
Means the founder of the slave dynasty. And the first female ruler?
Fezia Sultan.
Very good. She came over the throne in the year?
1236.
I think आप सबको बहुत अच्छे से याद रहेगा. Revision की जरूरत नहीं लग रही है.
Yes.
So we'll have a free lecture. Yes, continue, beta.
The Hindu kingdom of Vijayanagar. During the Sultanate periods, there were attempts to establish authority over South India. Alauddin Khilji was the first ruler to launch an attack. He carried away enormous wealth from Devgiri. Subsequently, Malik Kafur destroyed the kingdom of Warangal. The condition of South India worsened during the time of Muhammad Tughlaq. Simultaneously, the Hindu Empire of Vijayanagar and the Bahamani Sultanate were also established in South India. After the defeat of the ruler of Warangal, the two brothers on the Jadav clan, Harihara and Bukka, established the Vijayanagar kingdom under the inspiration of Swami Vidyaranya. The Vijayanagar kingdom was established in the south to the Tungabhadra river in 1336 CE, within a short period of 8 years, the kingdom was extended from the river Tugabhadra to Kanyakumari. Bukka ascended the throne after the death of Harihara. His descendants being weak, a new dynasty came to power. Krishna Devaraya was a powerful ruler of this dynasty. Krishna Devaraya's rule flourished in South India. He had good relations with the Europeans and was a lover of art and literature. He constructed canals in South India with the help of an engineer called Yomke. Foreign travelers who visited Vijayanagar had appreciated in grandeur. There were grand temples and forts in the kingdom. His glorious state was destroyed in the Battle of Talikota.
Very good, master. Yes, any doubt, beta, till here?
No, ma'am.
I'll open the PDF of this lesson. Just a minute, give me a moment. I have sent you, the notes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
On which date I had sent you, anyone remembers? Got it. Yes. So what it is, write a short note on Ghulam Dynasty. We already learnt about Ghulam Dynasty, right? Yes, Zainab.
Yes, ma'am.
Read this beta. Zainab.
Yes, ma'am.
Read this.
Delhi during medieval period. Question and answer. Number one, write a short note on Ghulam Dynasty. Ghulam Dynasty was established by Qutub ad-Din Aibak in the beginning of the 13th century CE, in 1206 AD. After the death of the Shahabuddin Ghori, his loyal commander and slave Qutub ad-Din Aibak took the control of the Delhi in his hands. Thus, by becoming the king of the Delhi, Qutub ad-Din Aibak established Ghulam Dynasty in India. Qutub ad-Din Aibak constructed Qutub Minar. After him, his son-in-law Iltutmish became king. He won the many battles and defeated many kingdoms of the India in the Delhi Sultanate. Iltutmish is known as the real founder of the Ghulam Dynasty. After the death of Iltutmish, his daughter Razia Sultan ascended the throne in 1236 AD. This efficient and capable queen was the first woman ruler on the Delhi. However, Amir Umrao was a female ruler, and so they ended the rule in India. Umrao's and Ulama's are the Muslim scholars trained in Islam and Islamic law. 6 years later, again, the Amir's enthroned the Nasiruddin, the son of the Iltutmish, as the king of the Delhi. Nasiruddin ruled over 21 years. After him, his wazir Alban became the king. Ghiyasuddin became the end of the disturbance and mismanagement in the Delhi. He ruled successfully for 22 years. However, his descendants were not powerful enough. They could not fight the Khiljis. Then the Khilji dynasty established its rule in Delhi.
Very good. Understood, Numita? How you have to frame the answer? How you have to write the answer? यस, जो हमने अभी पढ़ा है ना, तो उसका आंसर कैसे लिखना है, प्लस सी दिस फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. दिल्ली सुल्तानी वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन व्हिच ईयर? हां
1206.
हां देन डैश कंप्लीटेड द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ कुतुब मीनार.
मैम आपकी स्क्रीन बहुत लाइट है.
डैश कंप्लीटेड द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ कुतुब मीनार.
इल्तुतमिश.
यस एंड इल्तुतमिश असेंडेड द थ्रोन आफ्टर
आफ्टर
कुतुबुद्दीन ऐबक. सी सेम टाइप के क्वेश्चंस यहां पे भी है कि व्हेन वाज दिल्ली सुल्तान एस्टैब्लिश्ड?
इन बिगिनिंग ऑफ द 1200.
देन व्हाट इज कुतुब मीनार?
पिलर.
Understood everyone? It is a artistic pillar, right? Who was Razia Sultan? She was the daughter of Iltutmish and the first woman ruler of Delhi. All these points we covered, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt till here?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Yeah, so see, if you learn a big question answer, you will be able to answer all the small ones also. Objective,
yes,
answer, right?
Yes.
Almas, read the second one.
What? Write a short note on Qutbuddin Aibak. Number 1, Ghulam dynasty was established by Qutbuddin Aibak in the beginning of the 13th century, i.e. in 1206 AD. After the death of...
Beta, what do we say i.e.? We say that is, okay?
Okay. After the death of Shahabuddin Ghori, his loyal commander and slave Qutbuddin Aibak took the control of Delhi in his hands. Thus, by becoming the king of Delhi, Qutbuddin Aibak established Ghulam dynasty in India. Qutbuddin Aibak faced great difficulty in establishing his power in Delhi. However, with time, he became a successful ruler. He constructed a huge, grand and artistic pillar in Delhi. He named it Qutub Minar after his name. However, he died before he could complete the construction of Minar. Therefore, his descendant and son-in-law, Iltutmish, completed its construction. The Qutub Minar made Qutbuddin Aibak an immortal name in the pages of history in India.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
She's not audible, no?
She's audible.
Understood the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, the next question, write a short note on Qutub Minar. Yes, Nayani Modesa. Nayani Modesa is there?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Number 3 or number 2?
Nayani Modesa?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Number 3rd question.
Number 4. Write a short note on Qutub Minar. Qutbuddin Aibak, the king of Ghulam dynasty and the ruler of Delhi, constructed a huge, grand and artistic pillar in Delhi. He named it Qutub Minar after his name. However, he died before he could complete the construction of the Minar, and therefore his distinguished and son-in-law Iltutmish completed its construction.
The Qutub Minar made Qutubuddin Aibak an immortal name in the pages of history of India. The Qutub Minar has been constructed using the Hindu and Muslim style of architecture.
Architecture, okay. Pronounce it as architecture. Yes. Anyone any doubt till here?
Architecture.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
So see how much important it is to learn the long question answers.
Yes, ma'am.
I showed you parallelly the short question answers also, no?
Yes.
So learn long question answers whenever you get time, so that before exams, huh? But
yes,
so that you will be able to answer the